At this point, we have created your forecast by taking historical TV data and using the conditional independence model to deduplicate it with YouTube forecasting data to give you a likely expected forecast for a campaign containing both TV and YouTube. Now, let's look at the forecast based on your campaign setup. You'll see that some of the settings that you chose, like location, dates, and target demographic, are available above. Here, you can see that we've created a plan that contains both TV and YouTube. The next thing you should note is that we have two curves and two forecasts. These correspond to what we call the plan and the comparison. These are two versions of your media plan containing different amounts of YouTube and TV. So you can easily compare different types of plans against one another. You'll see in the headline that there is a plan, a comparison, and a difference. The plan corresponds to this bar on the side right here. The plan is automatically set to TV and YouTube budget split that maximizes the total potential one plus on target reach. The comparison is the status quo. You will find that the comparison matches the TV campaign details that you input at the first step, with the exception of the number of TRPs. Here, you will see key reach planning metrics across the two plans. We will show you one plus on target reach, average frequency. Please note that the average frequency is the average number of times people have been reached by your campaign message. You'll also see the total and the on target CPM. On target being the CPM corrected for only delivery against your selected demographic, target rating points, and cost per rating point. Down below, you will find the same comparison in a more visual format, where you'll see the reach curve. Reach Planner here shows you the reach of a TV-only plan compared to the TV plus YouTube plan. Demographic breakdown, where Reach Planner shows you breakdowns by demographics in all countries, plus reach and frequency against the population you want to reach of adults across various age groups. Then, there's TV viewership. In some countries, you'll have the ability to see the breakdown by TV viewership. This is determined by taking TV viewership for all adults age 18 and above, and breaking it down into three equally sized segments of people who are non and light TV viewers, people who are medium TV viewers, and people who are heavy TV viewers based on the amount of television they've watched in minutes or hours. Then, we reflect the combined TV and YouTube reach of the campaign against non and light TV viewers, medium TV viewers, and heavy TV viewers. Here's one of my favorites, the campaign table. This allows you to see the specific breakdowns of the individual YouTube campaign for the plan specifically. Now you have the ability to start making changes to understand the relative effects on your forecast of changing elements of your plan. For more information on how to review your forecast, see the link in the description below the video.